Hi guys, welcome to Mishi Blue Tarot. Welcome to this channel. This is Neelam and I am back for all of you with another reading today. So today we are going to be looking at messages that want to come through for you from the universe. Like if you believe in God, if you believe in spirit guides, whatever you believe in, and if you're looking for some advice. And if you're confused and you want to get clarity, you want to understand where to go, which path to take, then this reading is for you. If irrespective of the area, if it is your love life, it is your career, it doesn't matter. It has to, I mean, if you feel that you want some guidance from a divine source, then the cards can act as a channel for you to get these messages. All right. So today I've laid out three piles for you, as you can see. Pile number one is the red jasper crystal. Number two is the clear quartz crystal. And the third one is the amethyst. So I have picked up two oracle cards and just kept them to set the theme of the reading, and we'll be looking at more messages that want to come through for you. Alright, so I'll pause for 2 seconds. You can choose your piles. Alright, so let's begin. I'll start with the red jasper, pile one. Okay, so let's see, what does the universe want to say to you, pile number one, red jasper. Study, inner child. Okay, I'll read out the messages. Spirit has its own special way of letting you know that it's time to study again. From time to time, it's important to go back and learn, whether that's learning old things in a new way or learning something totally new. This is an opportunity to expand your mind. The inner child. Nurture your inner child and begin to express the awesome beauty you hold within you. We believe in a world where a formula exists for everything. Yet love and creativity have no formula. They do not need to be studied, simply nurtured. Regularly set aside some time to just play. Okay, so with these two cards, pile number one, you're being asked to constantly learn and unlearn. And if you're worried and bothered about certain experiences in your life which have made you very sad, which makes you feel that, oh my God, where did I land myself, or what did I do to myself? If that's the situation that you're in and you feel very, very irritated about it, try to understand that every experience has its own reason. So today, if you're looking for this reading and you're looking for an answer, it is because, now, I'm sure that there is some experience that might have taken place in your life and you're confused that why did it happen? The first message here is, it happened so that you could become wiser. That is the first and the most important message. You had to learn it this way. It has opened your mind. And I think you're already there. You have opened your mind in a lot of ways. You're already kind of there. You're opening your mind. You're opening yourself. You're talking to yourself in a lot of ways. Okay. And I'm seeing a lot of soliloquy happening. Also, I'm seeing that maybe this person or this situation that you're in has triggered you in a lot of ways to do a lot of inner child work. And you might have to do it. And probably your answers lie in your childhood. For a lot of you guys, I'm seeing your answers lie in your childhood. And that's the reason why you should regularly set aside some time where you are doing things that you used to do as a child or as a kid. All right. You have to do this so that you become better. Okay. Because I'm seeing that you have to kind of let go of a mindset or a way of thinking which is no longer helping you. It would have at a certain period of time, but now it is not. Now you have to let go of that formula or let go of that way of thinking so that a new formula can come in your life. Okay? Let's see. What else does the universe want to say to you at this point? It's majority of the message that I see that mainly what it is asking you to do is to let go and understand the reason behind why this happened. But you have to let go of certain things. This is for sure. You have to let go of certain things. Let's see. What else are the messages for you from the universe? There you go. Change, transformation, death. Bring about this change. And I think maybe as a child, you've had some trauma which needs to go so that you can be happy. And probably you're being a little rigid. You're still not being able to understand that why would something like this happen in my life? You're still not being able to understand. You're still thinking that, this cannot be the only reason why such a big thing happened in my life. Okay? But trust me, big things can have a very small lesson also. And a small lesson can have a very deep impact in your life also. It's a line that you can repeat, listen to once again. Because lessons and learnings come to us in a very unexpected way. You will never know why is it here and why did it come in your life. These things you might never know. Let's see, what else? Staying focused, hold the course. So the thing is, the process is still on. Impasse, reflect and redirect your energy. See, the thing is, what I picked from these cards for you is keep seeking. Like, I know that whatever happened or whatever the situation is has conflicted you in a lot of ways, and you could be in a spot where you are thinking, where you are contemplating, trying to understand that is this the solution? Why would this happen? Does this even make sense? A lot of questions. So the universe is telling you, or spirit is telling you, or whoever you believe in, the divine powers are asking you that get all your questions answered. Your questions that are coming for a reason in your mind. So get them answered and it's totally fine. Don't feel overburdened with it, of course, and don't kind of get into a zone of like just thinking about this situation. There are other things also. But at this point, do it. Because you are growing with it and it is a good sign. You should grow with time. Growth is always necessary. That's what I'm seeing. All right. Also, the study and this reflection card over here, this impasse, is telling me that time to time, you will be needing those breaks also to process a lot of things. Okay. To process a lot of things, you will need those breaks. You will need the time to understand yourself and to grow as an individual. Okay, let's see. What else is this about? The 10 of Wands falling, but let me see if this comes back again. What else is this about? Pile number 1. Okay, something to do with the Emperor, because I have it twice. Maybe it's a male energy. Okay, 4 of Cups and the Lovers. One more. And the Hierophant. Okay. 3 major arcanas. So guys, I feel that somebody will come in your life. The moment you stop being rigid and change the way you look at things, somebody or someone is going to step in who will give you what you deserve, pile number one. But you just have to change the way you look at things. I'm saying that you might have to release a lot of things from your mind, which I told you right in the beginning, okay? You might have to release, because, and this goes with my Instagram message today, it's like, if you don't release, you're blocking your own vision, okay? Now, this releasing can be a particular mindset. Like, for example, I'm just giving an example. I am in love with a person and I only think that this is the right person. I want this person only. But what if this person is not for your highest good? Alright? If you keep thinking in that way, then how would you even know that, okay, I might be deserving something better. I don't know. You have to get into that mindset. You have to embrace that mindset. What's happening is your rigidity, okay, your rigidity to this change sometimes can actually stop you from growing. Think. Pile number one, your major message is to think, because you actually need to think here. There's a lot of thinking work that is needed, pile number one. Now let me see what is the advice for you in this overall situation. I'll take this. Actually, okay. Oh my God, there is something about this emperor. I have the emperor once again. So some Aries significantly is very important in two major arcanas here. You need to either cut out your own rigidity, or this is a person's energy who you feel is your divine masculine, or you think is the right person, but actually is blocking your growth. Okay, you would know your situations. I'll read out the message. Logic and organization will increase your success. Take charge of the situation. Accept a leadership role. Structure and discipline is important. Be impartial and objective. Stand up for what you believe. Try to see all sides of the situation. You will win if your position is the one of integrity. So see, the thing is, I told you that you have to see all the sides of the story. Right now, I think you're really blocked with a particular vision that this is the person for me. And that's what Spirit is asking you to leave, to move away from that mindset that this is the only person made for me. Okay? And trust me, I understand. A lot of you might get offended when I'm saying this. You all might be like tuning in to listen to that. Okay, this is your soulmate. But it's not always like that, pile number one. Sometimes a certain people who come in your life, they have to make you feel a certain way so that you grow spiritually. And that is what is happening with you, or would have happened with you. But once that growth is done, if you keep holding on to that person, you will not grow further. And life is a growth story. Life is not stagnation. It never is. And that is why you see that different people who come in your life at different times of your life. To make you grow, to make you understand a lot of things. Okay? There are pauses. People connect after pauses again. So, do you see what I'm trying to say? It's like, it's a constant process of learning and unlearning. And you have to learn this. And then unlearn it when the time comes. Alright? So, that is what I have for you, pile number one. I hope this reading gave you some clarity that you were looking for. Please let me know in the comment section. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. And I shall see you soon again with another reading. And yes, you can follow me on Instagram. It's Mishi Blue Tarot Official. I do 3-card readings over there every day. So, I mean, if you're interested, you can tune in and check me out over there as well. Take care, and I shall see you soon again. Bye. Okay, so let's move to Pile number two, whoever chose this clear quartz crystal, pile number two. Okay, so let's see what does the universe want to say to you at this point. I think these readings are turning out to be short, and I'm actually keeping it short so that, you know, the messages are very crisp and clear. Let's see what does the universe want to say to you. Ground yourself. Being distracted, unfocused, tired, irritated, and impatient are all signs that you are ungrounded. Now is the time to become centered and allow spirit to help you ground yourself and reconnect with the divine source. Prayer. Okay, pile number two. If you've chosen this, again, this goes with my Instagram message a bit. If you've been manifesting something and it is not happening, keep praying and keep grounding yourself. Okay? If you feel that you're not being able to focus, it's okay. There are phases in life when you cannot focus, when you cannot really understand that, okay, do I want to even walk on this path? Is this even legit for me? Is this meant for me? You know, so you actually don't understand that, and this thought plays on your mind constantly, and that leads to impatience, that leads to anxiety. So if you're going through that, okay, then things will become better. This is an assurance from the spirit, okay, but the point is that you have to constantly keep doing your thing. Don't panic, don't worry, just keep doing your thing. I'm reading this out. Dear guardian angel, help me to be flexible in my attitudes and beliefs. Help me not to fear the transient nature of life. Help me to remember the eternal light which emanates from my soul. And the eternal light which emanates from the heart of every living thing. Help me to remember that I am eternally guided and loved by God and all creations. So, keep praying, keep manifesting, pile two. That is what spirit is telling you. Now this is something unconditional. Like, I'm not seeing that, I will not say what I don't see. It's not like I'm saying that your prayers will be answered, but let's be optimistic. If you're being asked to continue to pray, which means somewhere it is being heard, or somewhere somebody knows that you're praying, or you're asking for something. So keep doing that. Let's see what else does the universe want to say to you at this point? Queen of Swords, Five of Cups, Chariot, Justice, Seven of Wands, High Priestess at the bottom. Alright, so here what I see, pile number two, is that don't try to hold on to things that is not meant for you. Okay? I'm seeing that you need to speak up. You need to talk about what you're feeling. If you're sad about something, okay, move away from that. Okay, what I'm seeing is that maybe you're resisting some sort of an end. You're resisting some sort of a change. You're resisting some kind of a thing which will happen eventually. Okay. So you are being asked to not stop it. You're being told to not stop it. Because stopping it will only delay it and it will come back to you again. So if you do that, then it is not going to help you in any way. Okay? So you have to let this happen. That is what the universe is trying to tell you. And I also feel that you being rude and harsh and etc., etc., is a way through which you hide your feelings and emotions. But the point is that you can't keep doing it all the time. That can offend people also, but yeah, pretty much the energy that I see is that if you're stopping something from happening, don't do that. Okay? Let's see. What else does the universe want to say to you? Ascending the mountain, keep going forward. Wow. Stepping into power, you are strong beyond measure. Okay, so again, could be that this is a tough path that you're walking on. And you could be like scared and questioning yourself that will you be able to do this? But this is an assurance from spirit that yes, you will be able to do it. Don't worry. For a lot of you, this could be a marriage ending or this could be a relationship ending which you have to put an end to because you're not happy. Then spirit is telling you that don't feel afraid to express yourself when you're not happy about something. Because it's not like if you don't say, people will not get to know. Or if you don't express it, nobody would know that you're unhappy. If you keep hiding it inside yourself, then it is going to be there. Also, I see that people have chosen this file. Please practice things of grounding, like going and meeting people, socializing, gardening, meditating. Do things that will ground your energies, which will connect you to the divine source sometimes. Just working, or if you have been just working, that is not going to help you. Okay? Keep moving in the direction that you're moving. You're being guided at every point. So just keep moving. All right. Let's see. What else does spirit want to tell you right now? Nine of Cups, Three of Coins, Six of Cups. Work towards what makes you happy, pile number two. Don't try to run away from things that it's not like, okay, doing something for your own happiness is something that you shouldn't feel guilty about ever. That is what I'm seeing. You have to do things that make you happy as well. I see a little bit of guilt energy here, pile number two, but the point is that you can't keep living like this. Okay, the feeling of guilt can be surrounding you because you think that, okay, if I walk away, what's gonna happen? How are things going to pan out? You're scared. You're probably scared to take that step. Now, I'm seeing that if you don't, okay, if you don't, then you will be even more miserable. You'll keep being harsh on yourself. You'll keep being miserable with yourself. So here the universe is trying to tell you that, listen, chasing your happiness is not wrong and you shouldn't be feeling scared or guilty about doing that. Okay, so that is what I'm seeing. Now let me see one more advice for you from this deck. What does the universe want to say to you right now? Queen of Pentacles. Generous, practical, gracious, materialistic, the ability to make anything more beautiful. A love of family and home. Be practical about how you proceed. A love of art and beauty, a sensible approach. I'll tell you the meaning. And I have the Knight of Wands. Okay. And the World. Be free, pile number two. Be free. At the same time, it's not like it's not practical for you to do this. I'm not seeing a message like that. If you be free, then you're not being practical. That's not the thing. Okay, be free. Okay, I'm seeing that there is something that you want. You want to walk on that path, but you're a little scared about whether this is practical or not. So here's an assurance that it is practical. Do it. Okay. Trust your instincts, stay focused, and this thing requires immediate action, and whatever the situation is. It is because you are feeling that passion or you're feeling that determination towards this situation, and you should do it. It's not like I haven't got a single message that is telling you that no, your happiness is not something that, you know, you should proceed. There is something wrong here. In fact, if you hold on, it is going to be even more tough. Okay. All right, pile number two. So that's what I have for you. I hope this resonated. Please let me know in the comments. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. And I shall see you soon again with more readings. Take care and bye-bye. Okay, let's now move to pile number three, whoever chose the amethyst crystal. Let's see, what does the universe want to say to you? Self-love. Now is the time to love, nurture, and heal yourself. Self-love is not simply a state of mind about feeling good. It's a state of appreciation for yourself that grows and matures from action you take to support your body, mind, and soul. Prayer again. Wow. Dear guardian angel, help me believe that all is possible through love. Help me manifest my dreams and live an inspiring and fulfilling life. Help me to feel God's presence in every moment. Help me feel eternally loved. Thank you for being always by my side. Okay, I think whoever chose pile number two might have been attracted to this also, because the message seems to be a little similar. The point is that you are at a crossroads in your life where maybe you're being triggered to take some decisions. And the decision could be about choosing something which can hurt someone else, but it is for your highest good. And that could be making you a little reluctant. That's what I'm seeing. So the universe here is telling you that appreciate yourself by taking certain decisions which are good for your mind, body, and soul. Now, what this decision is, you would know. So, for example, if you're in a situation which is not actually, which is draining you, okay, which is taking a lot from you, you have to understand that you have to stop and you have to think. You have to think whether you can do this any longer or you cannot. And if you realize that you can't, then you should say it, because you're actually honoring yourself by saying it. And it is important. See, everyone has the right to be happy. In whichever way, all right? Whichever way you find happiness, you have the right to be happy. So if you figured out that this is the way I want to be happy, then that's how you're supposed to be. Alright? So nurture yourself. And if in that process you might land up hurting someone else, you have to make it clear to the other person that, see, I am trying, but it has started to take a toll on me and I can't keep doing this. You have to say it, okay? Let's see what else do we pick up from here. What does the universe want to say to you at this point? Queen of Wands, Three of Cups, King of Cups, the Tower, Two of Pentacles. This could be to do with a relationship. Could be that somebody was just attracted towards you and you thought of it in a different way. You thought, no, it's something bigger. And you had to blow it up. I'll take this. You had to blow it up. Because you felt that you're not getting what you deserve here. It made you feel miserable. I can see it, pile three. It made you feel miserable. You might have gone through very bad times, as in, like, maybe you just felt sleepless nights, because this tower is telling me that same thing. It hurt you. It did. But again, get up and say it's okay. Because these things happen in life and it makes you grow. Can't help it. Everybody goes through it. Everyone has their own journey. So here, instead of putting your head so much into this, look into the brighter side of the future. If you put an end to this, good you did. And these things are just kind of divinely guided sometimes. You cannot do anything about it. Okay? You will have to do certain things, and it's like a push from inside. Now don't regret it, because I see that you're thinking that, did I do the right thing? Should I have done this? Those thoughts are playing in your mind. No, it's not that. It had to happen. You can't help it. So don't doubt yourself so much that, did I do the right thing? You did. Okay? It's your right to be happy. You deserve to be happy. Whoever this is resonating with would know. And if you want something and you feel you're actually, I mean, if the situation right now is at that point that, okay, you know that you will not get that from here, then you should put an end to it. Okay? Let's see what else. Pile three. What does the universe want to say to you? Stepping into power. That's why I said pile 2 and 3 are going really well. This card was there for pile 2 as well. Let's see what else the universe wants to say to you. Narrow pathway. Tread thoughtfully. See, the universe is telling you one thing. That, see, you are confident, you have the power, but this is not an easy path. It's a very narrow path. You might be feeling alone. You might be feeling that there is nobody with you. And this you have to be mentally prepared for, because it's not like people are going to support you. Sometimes it can be, and I'm actually seeing that maybe you might be left alone, because the Two of Wands also tells me the same thing. But the point is that I'm not getting a vibe over here that you shouldn't do this, because you're doing this for yourself. I mean, there can be this instance that, okay, nobody is understanding you, but that is okay. It is possible that nobody will understand you. But that doesn't mean that you will stop understanding yourself and act as per what the others are saying, right? Let's see. What else does the universe want to say to you? The Hermit. Ace of Pentacles. Ace of Wands. Very clear message. I want to keep this here. Okay. It's very clearly telling me that decide whether you want stability or you want, maybe you have a connection which is giving you a lot of passion but not giving you stability. Okay. Maybe it's a third party situation, or it's a very casual relationship which is okay to go on, but it puts you in a spot sometimes because maybe you have feelings and the other person does not. All right, so there's a judgment moment here. You have to take a call whether you want to stay in this or you want to leave this, whether you want this connection or you don't want it. Because if you choose stability today, if you choose a relationship which has both, then you might have to quit this. You might have to leave this. And that's what I'm seeing, that maybe you develop feelings for this and you don't know whether you should walk on this path or not. You're scared. It's a narrow path because it's not easy. The temptation can be very strong sometimes. But either you give in to the temptation or you realize your value. I have the strength. Realize your power. Have faith in yourself. Okay? Now let's see what is the advice for you in this situation overall. Advice for pile number 3. Five of Swords, Four of Swords. Come out of this energy where you might have a tendency of feeling cheated. You might keep going back in circles. You might not understand whether this is what you want. Meditate, pile number 2, and actually pile number 3. Prayer and Four of Swords, both is telling me that, you know, you need to kind of go deep inside and decide, because I think this is temptation, a very strong temptation that you have, but you have to let go of this if you want to stabilize, because you give in at the moment when the temptation is very strong, but then again you realize it later or you regret it later that what did I do? I shouldn't have done that. So this situation is not trustworthy. Whoever's resonating would know what I'm saying. Any which ways to proceed further, you have to go inward and understand, draw healthy borders and then move forward. Alright? Okay, pile number 3, I hope this reading gave you the clarity that you were seeking. That's the message that I have for you. Let me know in the comments if this resonated. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. And I shall see you soon again. You can also follow me on Instagram. I do daily 3 card readings over there. It's Mishi Blue Tarot Official. And I love talking to all you guys. I read all your comments, even though sometimes I'm not able to reply, but I do. All right. Take care. Bye.